Madam, I implore you to be sensible.
Oh, I am being sensible. I swore I would kill them, each and every one of them. From the way I see it, I will do. I'm afraid my mind's made up.
But Mrs. Leclerc, Teddy Brown, he's just a second-rate, common, no-good horse thief. You kill him and the rest of his boys, well, you wind up in jail. Get on your horse.
Now, I know you're willing to do good and bad as it suits you. And maybe that's everyone's right. And maybe it's the right way to be. You seem to live by your own rules. In some ways, I admire that. Although maybe at times you seem a touch confused. Confusing?
Getting on, Marshal.
Well, that bastard is holed up tight as he can be. I've already had two men shot since last we spoke.
That's too bad. Luckily, I brought in the cavalry, so to speak.
You have, huh?
Yes. My associates. And what's more, I think I found a way of ensuring they don't get themselves shot. Like your deputies. Put those on.
Teddy Brown is a bad man.
One of the worst.
But there's folk in Blackwater, powerful folk, who asked my boss to get me to leave them alone.
I can imagine. Amos Lansing and Jeremiah Shaw, perhaps?
Well, I don't know. Maybe. My lord! Look at you!
I read about this. Australian, I believe. Always wanted to see if it works.
My friends, let me take you up. Come on.
Bring us Teddy Brown. Dead or alive.
Now, the fort is protected by blockades. See? At the front and rear.
Thank you. God damn you! God damn you!
No! God damn you, Teddy Brown!
Hello, Mrs. Leclerc.
Who killed my husband? Who killed my husband?
Your husband? That little milksot? I guess I imagine he was your brother. No woman would ever marry his kind. I did kill him. I did it. And he was begging for his life. Pathetic, really.
Who put you up to it? Who?
Lady, that's none of your damn business.